Welcome to this session. Here we shall discuss how to improve the performance of blowpipe in blast furnace. A suitable refractory is required for lining which protects the metallic surface of the blowpipe from overheating and to prevent huge heat loss through the surface of the blowpipe. Hot air at a very high pressure of about 4 kg per square centimeter and at a temperature in the range of 1000 to 1400 degree centigrade, along with pulverized coal, is passed through the blowpipe. Blowpipe has to withstand a very high thermal shock during off-blast period or during shutdown when that temperature pushed down very severely. Cold dust injection has also an erosion impact on the surface of the custom. Because of the tuyere jam or jam inside the furnace in front of the tuyere, fuel burning occurs inside the blowpipe, creating locally very high temperature. So, suitable custom refractory should have some characteristics. It should withstand very high temperature, that is high refractiveness, high thermal shock resistance, high mechanical strength like high RUL, CCS, BT to provide wear resistance under high temperature environment, low thermal conductivity and low permeability to prevent huge heat loss and to protect the blowpipe shell from overheating. Volume stability at high temperature should be very good. Low PLC and low coefficient of thermal expansion to withstand the thermal shock. Good wear resistance and corrosion resistance. High crack resistance. This is very important property of the refractory custable. Due to the generation of heavy stress because of thermal shock or other factor, crack may occur, but depending on the quality of custable, the rate of propagation of crack is low. If the crack propagates very fast and reaches the blowpipe shell, then overheating of the blowpipe metallic shell may lead to the puncture of the blowpipe. Under compulsion, furnace has to be shut down in an unplanned way for blowpipe change hampering production. Some typical examples have been shown here. All these customers are self-flow customers. Now we shall discuss about the important points of application. Previously and even now in many plants, 80 to 90% high alumina customers are used for the relining of blowpipe. Use of conventional custable is not at all suitable for the casting of blowpipe shell because of two reasons. First, conventional custable requires more water for its preparation, so during preheating or drying, that water comes out as vapor and that will create more pores in the product. So, development of more pores means there will be less mechanical strength. Second, to get the workable flowability of these conventional castables, more water, that means more than the specified norm, is required to be added because the mix has to pass through the annular gap of 60 to 70 millimeter in between metallic shell and mold. Again, more water means development of more pores, that means development of less physical strength in the cast product. Different low cement castable conforming to the suitable specification should be used. Low cement castable requires 4 to 6% water depending on the cement content as binder for the custom. As the water requirement is less for low cement castable, so less pore will be developed after drying or during preheating, improving different mechanical strength. Moreover, because of the low cement content, CaO, that means calcium oxide content, will be less in the mix. More CaO, that means calcium oxide, means more chance of formation of low melting compounds in the cast product during use at high temperature operation. Thus, sacrificing high temperature refractoriness. It is to be noted that low cement castable must be prepared in a pan mixture or similar mixture which can apply high shearing force on the castable during mixing with this low amount of water. It has been observed that some plants use simple civil concrete mixture which is not at all suitable when low cement castable is mixed with required amount 4 to 6% water in concrete mixture, then a small ball formation 1 to 1.5 centimeter dia occurs which prevents proper mixing of castable. To have a workable consistency, then more water is required to be applied, and that is beyond the norm, which affects all the desired mechanical properties.
The present practice is the use of self-flow castable, which is also a low cement castable, but having special characteristics of self-flowing nature under gravity after preparing the mix with a specified amount of water. It does not require external vibration to apply force on the mix for flow and removal of entrapped air bubbles. It can easily fill the space between pipe, shell and mold. There is no apprehension of improper compaction of materials due to constant of proper vibration in such a small gap. The special characteristics of self-flow castable, which is also a low cement castable, is developed by designing the mix composition using different sizes of materials in different ratios, maintaining specified size fractions of different materials in the crustable composition, that is the prime important factor to develop the cell flow crustable. Application of crustable plays an important role in improving the performance of blowpipe after selection of a suitable crustable based on different physical properties suitable for the situation.
Blowpipe shell should be fixed upright with a stand, which should be supported by a strong structure like any column of the shop. The queer end should be at the bottom side and the wider side, that means elbow end, at the top for easy pouring of the crustable mix. Arrangement of a platform near the stand is to be arranged for easy pouring of the prepared crustable mix. Inspection of the uniform filling all around and for proper application of vibrator for common low cement crustable.
To maintain uniform thickness of the refractory crustable inside the blowpipe shell, fixing of the mold centrally is very much important. It is better to use a rubber mold in inflated condition, or it may be a thermocol mold wrapped with polythene sheet so that no water can be absorbed from the castable during casting. For rubber mold, compressed air is required. To remove the mold, air pressure is released. No thrust is required to remove the mold. Thermocol mold also does not require removal of molds in the green condition and can protect the cast from any type of mechanical disturbance in its green condition. After casting, it is carefully removed from the stand and kept aside for curing. Then it is preheated for drying when the thermocol burns out. It can also be removed with a rod having sharp edges for making through passes. The remaining part of the thermocol will be burnt out during the flow of hot air blast through it. It may be two wooden pieces forming the former or two metallic pieces forming the former as observed in different plants. The use of two split mold is the worst practice. This type of mold is removed by hammering from the tweer end as the other end diameter is more and easy to remove. Sometimes it requires so much hammering that is sufficient to develop surface cracks or internal invisible cracks in the cast, which may lead to the premature failure during operation. So, to increase the life of the blowpipe and to ensure consistent operation, avoidance of this type of split former is necessary. Hollow, hard cardboard mold wrapped with cellophane paper is also a very good option for casting. There is no chance of mechanical damage for removal of this type of mold at the green stage of the casting, as it does not involve any removal process of the mold at all.
This paper mold simply burns out during preheating or during operation. Next important point is the water addition to the custable mix during preparation as per a specified norm. Addition of excess water more than the specified norm affects all the physical strength of the custable very badly, which is just not immediately visible, but overall life will be less. If less water is added, then it is very difficult to have workable consistency.
If it is LC custable, the mix will be too viscous to flow or spread, and some voids may be there, and entrapped air bubbles will not be released properly to develop high physical strength required for the improvement of the performance. In case of self-flow custable, addition of less water will not allow self-flow. The same type of problem as with LC custable will arise with self-flow custable. With LC custable, mechanical vibration after placing the custable in the position is the necessity for the desired result and improvement of performance. With self-flow custable, no such mechanical vibration is required. What will happen if mechanical vibration is given by vibrator during casting of self-flow custable? In this case, viscosity of the custable mix will be very less and it cannot suspend all the aggregate particles uniformly in the mix. There will be segregation or separation of different size particles. Heavier particles will be settled at the bottom first, and the most light particles will be floating at the top, others in between according to their weights. In that case, cast product will not have uniform strength in all sections. For improvement of life, technical discipline has to be maintained in all stages. After casting, important stage is the curing. At this stage, some hydrated crystals are formed due to the hydration reaction of the cement, which is added in the castable composition as binder. These segregate particles are entangled in the intermeshing and overlapping hydrated crystals. Thus, green strength is developed. At least 24 hours is to be allowed for that, and then molds are to be removed carefully to avoid any mechanical damage. Then it should be kept for air drying for at least 7 to 2 hours to have good results. This type of LC product is having very less porosity, for which water removal from the cast is difficult. If first removal is tried by simple heating, then because of the development of huge internal pressure from the internal water vapor, heavy stresses will be developed and there will be crack in the product. So drying and heating should be done very carefully. After drying, it should be heated at the rate of 15 degree centigrade per hour up to 180 degree centigrade. When adsorbed moisture, that means water which is physically attached to the particles, will be removed. Then to hold at that temperature for 8 hours for normalizations of the temperature throughout the product. Then to raise the temperature slowly at the rate of 15 degree centigrade per hour up to 600 degree centigrade. and to hold at that temperature for 8 hours to ensure removal of chemical water. During hydration or setting reaction of the cement present in the castable, hydrated crystals are formed as discussed. Up to this temperature of 550 degrees centigrade, these hydrated crystals break down and releases the water of hydration. This water remains as water vapor at this temperature. This type of cast product is having very less porosity and some pores are sealed. So it is difficult for this water vapor to come out easily. At this stage, if heating rate is very fast, then crack may develop due to the development of high pressure of the water vapor. Even explosion of the casting may occur. So heating schedule should be followed for the improvement of performance. Then after natural cooling, it can be safely used. One thing has not been discussed about cooling after casting during curing. In this case of use of LC castable or self-flow castable and casting of a thinner section like 60 to 70 millimeter, water cooling is not so much required because this type of LC contains only 4 to 6% cement. So heat evolution due to hydrogen reaction will be less. After removal of mold, water can be spread over the surface for cooling of the cast, as even after 24 hours, setting reaction continues and development of green strength continues. In the last part, for better performance and to avoid breakdown, regular monitoring of the blowpipe condition during operation is required to avoid any uncertain failure arising out of the operational problem or workmanship problem during casting or non-conformation to the technical discipline associated with the casting. If regular measurement of temperature of the blowpipe surface is done with infrared thermometer, then failure can be avoided. Generally, 250 degree surface temperature is good. Because of erosion or major cracks developed due to the thermal shocks or jamming inside the tuyer or due to jam inside the furnace in front of the tuyer, surface temperature rises gradually. It can be permissible up to 350 degree centigrade. After 450 degree centigrade, it is alarming and it should be changed with new one. For modern high volume blast furnace, to avoid such type of failure, continuous monitoring from the control room is done through automation by putting temperature measuring sensors 3 to 4 numbers surrounding each blowpipe shell, and that reading is displayed in the control room. Fixing of a camera at the peephole also enables to have the inside conditions of the blowpipe and any jump inside the furnace in front of the tuyer, which leads to the burning of the fuel inside the blowpipe and damages the castable. This helps to take proper action accordingly. So, for the improvement of blowpipe performance, three things are very important: proper selection of a suitable castable, application of the castable following technical norms, and monitoring of the blowpipe condition during use at regular interval. To reduce the huge heat loss through the blowpipe surface continuously, the recent development is the use of an insulation castable in 15-20 millimeter thickness over the blowpipe inside metallic surface as the first layer, and above that common low cement castable or self-low castable as the working layer. Hope these will be helpful in getting primary information for the improvement of blowpipe performance in blast furnace. Thank you.